sometimes complicated motions can actually be composed of motions of many different frequencies. And when that's the case, the type of mathematical analysis that's useful is called Fourier series. What we're going to use Fourier series for is to solve a partial differential equation. And you'll see how our solution then will be written in terms of a Fourier series. So what is a Fourier series? It's a way of representing a function. So here we're going to have a function f of x, which is supposed to be a periodic function, means it repeats itself every 2L. So periodic with period 2L, okay? How do you represent then f of x as a Fourier series? There's a rather fixed expression for that, which I can write down. We write f of x equals a constant term, which we write as a naught divided by 2, plus a series, the sum from n equals 1 to infinity, of these coefficients a sub n times cosine n pi x over l plus b sub n plus times sine n pi x over l. Okay? That's the general form for a Fourier series. The use of the expression cosine n pi x over l, because cosine is a periodic function, when x goes from 0 to 2l, then the cosine function will just repeat itself. And the same for the sine function. So this expression will turn out to be periodic with the period of 2l. These coefficients, a naught, an, and bn, for n equals 1 to infinity, have to be determined in terms of this function f of x. To determine them, we use some relations that are called as orthogonality relations. Orthogonality relations. And those are relations concerning these cosine and sine functions. So let me write down what they are. If you integrate from minus L to L a cosine function, cosine n pi x over L, times a cosine m pi x over L, where n and m are two different positive integers, say, and we integrate this dx, what you get is L, but you only get L when n and m are equal. Otherwise, you get 0. That's called the orthogonality relation, because n and m are not equal, you get 0. To represent that, we use something called the Kronecker delta. So this piece here, this function here, is called the Kronecker delta, and it satisfies that delta nm is equal to 1 when n equals m, and 0 when n is different than m. So this is an orthogonality relation for these cosine functions. You can prove this by doing the integral. Many of you have done a cosine squared type of integral in calculus. I won't do that here. We'll just assume that one can do this integral. The other orthogonality relations are the integral from minus L to L sine n pi x over L sine m pi x over L dx. And that again is equal to L times delta n m, when n and m are positive integers. And the last orthogonality relation is the integral from minus L to L of a cosine n pi x over L times a sine m pi x over L dx. And that's always equal to 0. Okay. Using these relations, we can solve this Fourier series for the A coefficients and the B coefficients. I can give you one example of how that would work. Let's say we wanted to find the B coefficients. To find the B coefficients, what we would do is we would integrate the left-hand side. So we'd take the integral from minus L to L of f of x. And we want to find b sub n, say. So we would multiply by sine n pi x over L and integrate. And then what would happen? So if we multiply this constant by sine n pi x over L and integrate dx, we would get 0. That term would go to 0. If we multiply this cosine by a sine, we would have to change this dummy variable in the summation. Instead of saying from n equals 1 to infinity, we would have to choose m equal 1 to infinity. And then this would be a sub m cosine m pi x over L. If we multiply by sine n pi x over L and integrate dx, then this third orthogonality relation would give us 0. So the only thing we would have left is this last term. So this would be equal to the sum, and then I'm changing the n there to m. So m equals 1 to infinity. And then we would have a b sub m. And then we integrated. So we would have an integral from minus L to L. And then we would have here, we would have our sine n pi x over L. And from this one, because we changed n to m, we would have a sine m pi x over L. And we integrated dx. So now we would make use of our second orthogonality relation. So this integral would be L delta nm. So this would be the sum from m equals 1 to infinity, b sub m, times L delta nm. And now delta nm is 0 unless m is equal to n. So every term in this sum will be 0 except the term where m is equal to n. And then we get L times Bn. Okay? And then we can solve that for Bn. Okay, so that's how you find the B's. You get the A's the same way. I should just write down what the expressions are. So we have A sub n then is given by the integral. Or you have to divide through by L. So it's given by 1 over L times the integral from minus L to L. And it would be f of x times cosine n pi x over L dx. So A sub n's are given by this integration. And that's also true for A0, the first A coefficient, because that's why we stuck the 2 there, so that this formula would also work. The other one then would be b sub n equals 1 over L minus the integral from minus L to L of f of x sine n pi x over L dx. Okay, the mathematics of Fourier series is more complicated than this. One has to consider when the Fourier series converges to the function, things like uniform convergence and other mathematical problems. But I think engineers basically are users of Fourier series. They don't need to understand too much theory. So let me explain to you, let me review for you then what you do need to understand. So we're talking about representing a function f of x that's a periodic function with a period of 2 times capital L. L is typically some related to some length of the system. We write the Fourier series as f of x equals a naught over 2, a constant term, plus the sum from n equals 1 to infinity of a sub n times cosine n pi x over L, plus b sub n times sine n pi x over L. The use of the cosine and the sines ensure that this function is periodic with period 2L. If you want to find these, what are these coefficients in terms of f of x, you have to make use of these orthogonality relations. You only need this in the derivation, but after you've derived it, you don't need it anymore. After the derivation, what you find is that you can write the coefficients in terms of integrals over f. A sub n is 1 over L times the integral from minus L to L of f of x times cosine n pi x over L dx, one integral. B sub n is another integral where instead of multiplying f of x by cosine, you multiply by sine. In the next video, I'll talk a little bit more about the Fourier series. And eventually, then, we'll be using this to solve a partial differential equation. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.